So we are discussing about friction. Yesterday I stopped near. Will the friction produce heat? Yes, the friction will produce heat. Yesterday I showed for you the examples of that. Then today we are talking about the increasing and decreasing of friction. Increasing and decreasing of increasing and decreasing of friction. How can we reduce the friction? For suppose yesterday itself I told for you, when it is raining, did you understand? If you are going very fast in the rain and if you keep a sudden brake, what will happen? Immediately your cycle turns and it will skid. Why? Because when it is raining at that particular time, what will happen? The mud which is present on the ground will be very slippery. Is it correct or not? So at that moment, when you are riding the bicycle very fast and if you give a sudden brake, what will happen? Immediately you will skid down. There what we have to do? Should we increase the friction or should we reduce the friction? We have to reduce the friction. At that moment, what we will do? We have, when it is raining, we should never go very fast. At that moment, what we have to do? We have to reduce our speed. Did you understand? We have to reduce our speed when we are riding the bicycle. We have to see that one. There we have to go very slow. If we feel that it is slippery, we have to just keep a, no, we should never keep a sudden brake. What will happen means immediately we will fall down. Next thing is, when we are moving very fast, now I am riding a bicycle, at that moment, bicycle or bike, whatever it may be, if there is a sand was present there, there also how I should go? I should go very, there I have to reduce my friction. If not, the sand, if I am going very fast, sand is there, means again I will slip there because the sand is slippery. Did you understand? In the muddy place where the water is present, there we have to. Did you observe any time when we are wearing slippers and when we are wearing shoes or something, they will be grooved down. Means it will not be plain, it never will be plain. See in your textbook, grooved means what it will be. There a designed shape will be present at the under of your foot. What is that grooved structure which is present to our grooved structure which is present to our shoe? It is giving support. Means it is giving a grip. It is giving us a grip to walk. That's why, see, whenever that grooved is present, whenever that grip is given to that shoes or slippers, when we are moving in water or when we are moving in a slippery area also, there also we can, we can reduce our friction. If we are wearing that and if I am moving very slow, like this, if I am walking, I'll be in a correct position. If not, if in that situation also I'm moving very fast, what will happen? I'll skid and I will fall down. Now, the situation is there, oil is there, water is there, when I'm walking, I'm asleep. But which is stopping me not to fall down? Which is stopping me not to fall down? It is the grip which is present to the shoes. There, in the first case, while I'm riding the bicycle or when I'm walking by wearing the shoes or slippers, what is happening? The grip. Even did you observe the tires? When we buy a new cycle for that tires also, you can see that a grooved structure will be there. After using for 5 to 6 months, you can see that the tires will become very smooth in nature. If the tires become very smooth, at that time if you are giving any brake, what will happen? You will slip down. First case, when we are having a new cycle and when we are riding and when we give a brake for that one, it will not happen. We can, it reduces the friction at that particular time. So, it is shoes or if it is cycle or if it is a car, if it is a bike, or if it is something, you can see that the tires which are present to that one or the bottom of the shoes will be grooved. What is happening? This grooved nature will support support us not to fall down, and these grooved nature will give grip for us to reduce the friction. Did you understand? In this way we can. Next, when I am playing a carom board. See, when we are playing caroms, two games over, three games over, when I'm ready to move the striker, it moves very hard. What is happening there? The smoothness of the board was reduced. So I have to increase friction there. What I have to do? I have to increase the friction when I am using a carom board. Why? Because after that 2 to 3 games, you can see the board will become rougher, the coin will not move, the striker will not move. So at that moment, what I have to do? I have to increase the friction. So at this moment, what is happening means we will take the powder and pour on this one. Which powder? Coarse powder. Coarse powder. What is meant by coarse? Please listen here. What is meant by coarse means it is rough in nature. So that rough powder I will apply on the board. What will happen at that moment when I move the striker moves easily. There what did I do? I increased the friction. Why? Because there must be free movement in the coins and the striker. Why? Because the coin should enter into the hole. Because of that, I increase. In the first case, what we did, the grooved, the tires and the shoes are reducing the friction. Here, the coarse powder is increasing the friction. You can observe that the gymnastic, who will play gymnastics? You have idea of gymnastics? They'll catch the ropes, they will hear one body, they'll jump from here to there and do feats on that. These are called as gymnastic. That people also should have a grip. Why? Because they are ready to catch the rings. They are ready to catch the smooth sofa set. If they are using their fingers and if they are doing, what will happen? If a sweat is present to our fingers, to our hands, immediately the person will slip and he may break his hands and legs. So at that moment, what he has to do? At that moment, they also will apply powder to their hand. When you are playing kabaddi, you see, when you will play kabaddi, you will apply mud to your hands. Why you will apply mud to your hand? If your hands are sweaty, you can't drag the person. Why? Because you have to hold him and drag him out. When your hands are slippery, what will happen? He will just push you out and he will run out. So he will win, you will be out. At that moment, what you will do? You will, when you are playing tug of war, you have idea, no? With rope, this side few people, this side few people. What you will do? At that time also, you will apply mud to your hand. Why? Because you want to make your hand rough. If it is slippery, the other person will win. So, we will, in that way, in the gymnastics also, they will use, even in the carom board also, they will use coarse powder for what is that, to reduce the friction. Next thing is, in our houses, the nuts, bolts, yesterday itself I told for you. So, when they are making sound, the machinery, when we are using number of times the machinery, it also will produce a lot of sound. Okay, then when we are using cycle mode, that also after a few days, it produces sound. In our houses, the doors and windows also will creak, make a lot of sound. At that moment, what we have to do means, we have to use the lubricant to reduce the sound. We have to use the lubricants. What are the lubricants here? Oil, grease. Okay, such type of things we are using to reduce the irregularities or interlockings, to reduce the irregularities or interlockings. We will say that one. To reduce the irregularities and interlocking between the objects, we will use lubricants. Means in machinery or in grease, in our house, if you are observing daily when you buy a new cycle, what you will do? You will have more concentration on that one. After 6 months, it will become old, you also will throw that out. But up to from 5 to 6 months, you will have a very interest on that one. Daily, you will clean that without having any mud. Weekly once you will apply oil to that one to see the free movement of chain, pedals, etc. Even in big industries also, they will apply these grease and oil. Lubricants will be applied to see the free movement of machinery. Free movement of the machinery, they will use lubricants. Did you understand here? How to increasing, how to increase and how to decrease the friction. What are the ways we are following? Next one is rolling friction. What is next one? We are discussing about the rolling friction. Here in this rolling friction, you can see that. See, now I am going for a tour for 10 days. See, 10 days is my plan. Means I have to carry many things for this 10 to 10 days. And my bag was ready. It is very heavy. I have to carry like this and I am moving here, I am moving there, I am holding on head, I am keeping here, I am doing all whatever nonsense I want, I am doing to carry that heavy bag. If two wheels are present to that bag, imagine once when two wheels are present to that one, just I will drag like this and go. The weight, total weight before where it was, the total weight before it was on my shoulders. Is it correct or not? Now the weight went to the wheels. The weight went to the wheels. It is not to my hands. So the total bag is carried by this rolling. I don't need to apply much force on that. Is it correct or not? Now two plates are in my hand. I am holding these two plates and I am rubbing them with each other. Will they move freely? It will not happen. Is it correct or not? Now I take a marble and place on one plate and another plate I am keeping and I am rotating. In these two cases, in which case you can see that there is free movement in these plates? In the first case, there is no free movement in these two plates. Why? Because these two plates stick with each other, it cannot move freely. But in the second case, you see that when I kept a marble in between and when I am rotating, the plates are rotating freely. A book was placed on a table. This one you will do in class also. When teacher is telling lesson, if you are not interested, your work is that only. You will place a book on the table and try to push the book. What will happen? It is taking little bit of time to move. Now keep a pencil or pen under the book. Here a pencil or pen. And on this you keep a book and you push the book. What will happen? In which case the book is moving very fast? In the first case or in the second case? In the second case, when a pen or when pencil is there, the book moves very fast than this one. A toy car you prepare. Now drag a toy car. Tie a thread to the toy car and you drag it. No wheels for that car. No wheels are there for that car. Just you prepared a car and you tied a thread to that one and you are dragging. Imagine how it will be. It won't be good. But you just connect a four wheels to that car and you drag them. In the two cases you can see that in the second case when I connected the wheels to the car, it is easy for me to push the car than in the first case. Is it correct or not? So what is the use of rolling friction means? It helps us to move heavy objects very freely. It helps us to move heavy objects very freely. For that purpose, we are using this rolling friction. Now, what is rolling friction? When one body rolls over the surface of another body, the friction offered is called rolling friction. The friction offered is called as a rolling friction. Try to understand what is rolling friction. When one body rolls over the surface of another body, the friction offered is called as a rolling friction. The friction offered is called as a rolling friction. You can understand here. The last one is we are going to discuss about fluid friction. The last one we are talking about the fluid friction. We will observe, see here, when water is there. Now, you can observe that normally water is there, nothing will happen. When we are stirring, now I added sugar to that one and I'm stirring that. For what purpose I'm stirring this one? To see that the sugar should be soluble in water. The sugar should be soluble in that water. At that person, when I am stirring like that, you can see like a tornado it is forming. Is it correct or not? Like a tornado it is forming. And there, you can see that the fluid friction will act on that one. The fluid friction will act on that one. Now, how it is useful for... Now, you can see that the fishes will swim in water. Is it correct or not? The fishes will move from one place to another. Already we know that how the fish will move in a zigzag like this. Means when it moves its head this side, the tail will be in opposite direction. The tail is to this direction, means the head will be. Means in head and tail, when they are moving in the water, they will be in opposite direction. Why they are in opposite direction means when the head part is like this, the tail will jerk, and the tail part is like this, the head part will jerk. In this, a friction is acting between these, fish when it is moving in the water. In the same way, what is happening, we can see that the birds will fly in the sky. According to what purpose they are moving, they will move in a streamlined motion. How the birds will move in a streamlined motion, that they will see the wind direction and they will move. By seeing the birds itself, what they did, invented the aeroplane. The aeroplane always moves in a streamlined motion. You can see that one. Where, according to the wind blow, you can see. What is here, we are discussing about the fluid friction. Here, when we are just stirring the water, you can find that one. Normally, you cannot find any friction. But when we are rotating, you can see that the friction will be present in that one. Now, let us see the definition of the fluid friction. The frictional force the frictional force exerted by fluids is called fluid friction. The other name for fluid friction is called as drag. What is the other name for fluid friction? The other name for fluid friction is called as a drag. See, what is rolling friction? One body rolls over the surface of another body. The friction offered is called as rolling friction. What is fluid friction? The frictional force exerted by fluid is called as a fluid friction. The other name for fluid friction is called as drag. For suppose, if I keep an object in an inclined plane like this. I took an ice cube, I took an eraser, I took a coil. See here, I took a wooden plank, okay? And on this wooden plank, I kept the wooden plank in an inclined position. To one side, I kept ice cube. To other side, I kept eraser. The other side, I kept a coil. Which one will move faster? The ice cube will move first. Is it correct or not? Why the ice cube moves faster than the eraser and coin? Because the fluid, the water which is present in the ice cube, is helping the ice cube to move faster. It is helping the ice cube to move faster. So, we are telling here that this is there the fluid friction is acting on that one. Did you understand what is rolling friction and what is fluid friction? Then tomorrow we will continue. Thank you.